Welcome to Watercolor Lessons with Kathy. I'm Kathy Nichols, and I'm a lifelong artist, painter, and teacher. I help students of all ages tap into their creativity with watercolor. Watercolor is a great way to express yourself, and it's easy to get started and fun to do.
My watercolor lessons are designed for beginners of all ages. No theory and not too technical. Just follow along with me.
I hope you join me to learn how to paint with watercolor. I can't wait to see your paintings. Welcome to the next lesson in our cat series. Today, we'll paint an orange tabby. Our favorite cat was one, and her name was Olivia. We adopted her from a shelter, but because of predators where we lived, she had to stay inside all the time. My parents came to visit, and they fell in love with her. They were lonely and didn't have family close by. They had a safe place where she could go outside and chase mice and frogs the rest of her life. We'll use 3 brushes, 8 paints, and 6 techniques. Watch my video, Best Materials for Watercolor Beginners, to see where to get them. The link to the video is in the description and in the corner of the screen. Be sure to check below for more useful information and links. Let's have some fun and paint. Let's spray our pans of paint here. And put some water in our palette. In this painting, we will be using a template, and I have my template here. So take your liner brush and load it with yellow ochre with your liner brush. There we have the outline for the cat. Let's start here on the ears. Add some water to your brush and soften the line here. Okay. And then do it on the other side here, a little bit with the water. Load your brush with a yellow ochre and let's start forming part of the ear here. And then we want to leave a white space there. And come down here, and about right here is going to be the start of the eye of the cat. And then the nose comes down. My paint is a little bit faint, so I'm adding more color. And it's going to come all the way down to about right here. And here's the bridge of the nose. And then right here's the start of the other eye of the cat. Let's spread some of that color around. Right here is going to be the tip of the nose. Spread some more of the color out here. And with watercolor, you always want to start with the lightest layer, and then you can get darker. And make a definition of the nose is here. And then it comes down, and there's part of the cheek, and then it divides here. And then the chin of the cat. The chin of the cat will be right below the nose there. So you will want to do a line, and then do a circle, kind of a half moon shape. Okay. So go ahead and load your liner brush with more yellow ochre. Now on this ear here, there's some light showing through. So I want to leave some white space. And about right here, it gets darker. And then carry it up a little bit on the ear. Now this seems a little yellow to me, so I'm going to add a little bit of the cadmium red here to make it more of an orangey tabby type color. So I'm bringing that color down. Bringing around this way to the other side of the ear. And then put some of it here by the eye. And I'm going to add some water and thin that paint right there and spread more of that paint along here. And right here on the forehead, there's kind of streaks. So I want to leave some of the white there and add some of that color. Again, the mixture is yellow ochre and cadmium red. And carry it on to the other side here. Leaving some white. Okay. And on the other side, let's make the definition of where the eye is. Like that. Now let's stop and first I notice this is a little bit strong. I'm going to lighten that by just spreading the paint more. Okay. Now, the eye on the cat is more of a yellow than orange color. So we will use some of the lemon yellow with a yellow ochre touch and make the shape of the eye here. And there's going to be a black part in there, and I want to leave a little white space, like there's light reflecting on the cat's eye. And I'm going to leave a little white space about right there. And then complete the circle. And then on the other side, now this is a side view, so the circle is going to be completely close to the bridge, to the bridge of the nose there. Like that. Okay. So let's switch brushes to round with pointed tip, and we will be working on around the eye and around the nose in here. Wet your brush and then load it with yellow ochre. And cadmium red. And let's start by putting some color down below the eye here. And just spreading it a little bit here. Now I think that that's a little bit, almost too orange. Let's try adding a little burnt sienna to our mixture. Well, that didn't change it that much. That's okay. Let's come back up around the ear here. Side. I'm going to wet my brush a little bit so I can spread the paint. Come up around the eye there. and spread some down below here. And if you see areas that look too dark, just wet your brush and you can spread the paint. And if you need to, grab your paper towel and dampen, take some water out of your brush so you can lift some of that paint out if you need to. Now, still a little dark there. Now, the ear, there's a little pinkness to it. So we are going to take a touch of the crimson and really water it down. You don't want it too strong. And just add some on the ear here. So it has more of a flesh kind of color. And that looks a little red to me, and I'm going to change that by just adding a touch of yellow ochre. And dilute it with some water. Like that. And that's a little better. It's not quite so bright but subtle. Then on the other ear, we want to do the same thing. Like that. Now it's time to give it a quick dry. Now let's go back to our liner here and let's work on the eye here. Dip your brush and load your brush with burnt sienna. There's some darkness around that eye and my brush is a little bit too wet. Need more paint, less water. And outline the eye there. And then there's some darkness here, so I'm going to carry that down a little bit into the nose here. Come around this side. like that. Now let's go to the other side, doing something similar, loading your brush. Like so, and then even carry some of the darkness out a little bit here. Okay, now the nose. Our cat doesn't look very pretty yet, but we're still working on it, so have patience with yourself in the process. So the nose has a little pink to it, so we're going to use our touch of crimson and give it a base coat here, kind of a layer. Now that seems a little bright to me, but we're gonna add a touch of the burnt sienna. Actually, let's lift some of that color out, make it lighter. And you can just do that by simply have your brush damp and lift the paint out with your brush. Let's carry the color a little bit down here. Okay. This nose seems a little flat, so I want to kind of make a little bit of a curve to it. Like so. And on this nose, there's little spots. Sometimes when you look at a cat's nose, they have like little spots. So I'm going to put some little spots by using my liner brush and load it with some burnt sienna. That one was kind of looks funny, so I'm just going to kind of make it like it's part of the nose going up there. Going up to the bridge of the nose. So you can carry some of those spots up on the nose. Like so. Okay. Let's take our liner, and the cat has a black part of the eye. So to do the color on that, you want to mix your ultramarine blue and your burnt umber. And there I left the white spot, and I'm going to go around it and make that slit. Like so. Now to do the other one. This is a side view, so we want to make it more off to the side. like so. Okay. So let's stick with our liner brush. And as I'm looking to this, I think we need to make a little bit of a curve here and put some color here and extend this out line more. So using the mixture of the burnt sienna and cadmium red, I have some here on my palette, you might. Let's start at the bridge of the nose. Carry it down. Come back up by the ear. Up onto the top of the head. And load your brush as needed. I need to load mine. And you will want to leave some white spots. Usually when I look at a tabby, I see some white streaks. That looks better. Has more of a curve there. Carry out this way, down on the other side. I need to wet my brush. Then come down by the nose and add some of that color. And come on the other side here. Now we need to add a little more color under the chin here and carry some of that color up through the neck here. So load your brush again with a burnt sienna and the cadmium red. Bringing it down by the neck here. This cat is well fed. A little bit on the chubby side. Okay, now the eye is not totally yellow, so we want to use some of this mixture of the burnt sienna and the cadmium red a little bit on the outer edge of the eye and kind of pull it in. make kind of some lashes or streaks. Now, if you think they're too bright, again, you can dampen your brush and lift some of the paint out, which I'm doing. And then go ahead and do the other eye on the other side. Now let's give it a good dry. Now, as I look at this painting so far, this side is not as dark. And I want to add some hair, that's some fine hair that's in the ear there. So let's go ahead and take our mixture of the burnt sienna with the cadmium red. That's a little too dark. I'm going to water it down. A bit more like that. Now, to make the kind of the fine hair is you just kind of want to do like that so it, and not a lot, just the ear has some light and it kind of reflects and you see that fine hair in the, on the ear in the cat. And then let's go ahead and do the same thing on the other side. Okay. Now, cats usually have some whiskers right about here. So let's add some fine lines there. I need a little more paint on my brush. You might need it too. And then on their whiskers, sometimes there's some dark spots. And I'm going to make those dark spots with burnt umber straight on the brush. And like so. And a little darkness here with that line that comes down to the mouth. Okay. I do want to darken the area around the eye. And with that, I will be using the mixture of burnt umber and cadmium red. Just outlining the eye. Right here. A little bit on this one. I'm carrying some of that color on the eye duct here, like so. Okay. So now I'm going back with the mixture of burnt sienna and cadmium red here. And add just a little more color on the neck here. Water that part down. I like my little fat cat. Looks like the cat is in deep thought. Now, you can leave this like that and have the white background, which is your own personal reference, your personal taste, what you would like to do. So now if you are ready to stop, you can stop at this point on the video or continue and we will add background. So let's get ready and start that background. And with that, we will use our mop brush. And you can do this actually two ways, by spraying or just using your brush to wet the paper. And since we have some paint already on there, and we want to be careful not ruin the image, we will just carefully put water around the cat, wherever there is white space. Now let's use some of our intense blue here. Now I'm starting at the top and I'm going to spread that paint. Just
around that cat. Now, if you want to create a little texture, you can take your paper towel and dab it. And that will kind of give it some organic or shapes, just some little shapes there to give it some depth. Like so. So maybe this cat is sitting outside on a sunny day and the sky is blue. And I like using the sky background, just a light blue wash to complete the painting. So there's my happy fat cat. Or happy cat. I enjoyed painting with you today. And I hope you enjoyed it too. I'd love to see photos of your creations. You can email them to me at the address on our YouTube About page. To suggest something you'd like to paint, please let me know in the comments. To give watercolor a try, please subscribe to my channel and take a lesson or two. Please join me next time when we'll paint another pretty kitty. Take care, be safe, and see you soon.